So yesterday we heard how Lord Chaitanya took sannyas and how after taking sannyas he came to visit the home of Advaita Acharya at Shantipur. And then his mother came. And many devotees also came from Mayapur. They all came to see Lord Chaitanya as a sannyasi. So it was arranged at Lord Chaitanya's mother's request that Lord Chaitanya would go to stay in Jagannath Puri. Yeah, he's a sannyasi, he can't go home. Can't go home, his wife is at home, so he can't go there. So he's going to Jagannath Puri and he went with the four devotees. So we heard yesterday how on their way to Jagannath Puri they came to a very nice temple. Right, who remembers the name of the deity there? Anybody was here yesterday? You heard? Yes, right, Gopinath. And what did he steal? What did the deity do? What did he steal? Right. Yes. So you got. So the deity is called Kshira Chora Gopinath. If you go to visit. Yeah, if we go there to Ramuna one day on the way to Jagannath Puri, if we stop there, we can also get some sweet rice. We can taste the sweet rice. All right. Different temples are famous for different kinds of prasadam. What about in Beijing? Jiaozi, is it? Jiaozi. Jiaozi Chora Gopinath. A deity stole the jiaozi. Or Manto Chora Gopinath.
Manto?
So, who told the pastime there? Who knew the pastime of the deity? Who told the story? Who could have told it? Nobody remember. Tie, tie. Who could have told it? Just make a guess.
Is it meant when the Puri? Poor. No.
No. They were telling the story of Madhavendra Puri, but who was telling? Madhavendra Puri was before Lord Chaitanya. He was a long before.
Lord
Chaitanya told this story. And who told Lord Chaitanya? How did he know the story? Yes, Ishvara Puri, very good, yes. Who is Ishvara Puri? Who is he? Yes, right. And how did Ishvara Puri know the story? Yes, right. Now, Madhavendra Puri was his guru, so they know Ishvara Puri knew about his guru's activities. Do you know any other disciples of Madhavendra Puri? Ishvara Puri is a disciple of Madhavendra Puri. Do you know any other disciples of Madhavendra Puri?
Advaita.
Yes, very good, Advaita. Madhavendra Puri is the guru of Advaita. So they're all in the Madhva Sampradaya. Lord Chaitanya took his initiation in this line from Madhva Acharya.
Yes,
so, okay, so after seeing the deity of Gopinath and tasting the sweet rice, then they came, they're walking, and they come to another place, they come to a town, and they go to see the deity also there in the next town. All right, we heard about the Gopinath deity. Now we're going to see this other another deity in the town. On the way to Jagannath Puri, it's in a town called Katak.
在去加纳坡的路上呢，还有另外一个镇叫帕塔那个镇子，然后那里有另外一个庙，另外一个神像。昨天我们听了勾地纳的神像的消失光，然后今天我们来讲述他的故事。
So this temple Lord Chaitanya is going to see now is the, also is a good deity of Gopal. And Gopal is very famous deity because he became a witness. He became a witness for a wedding to take place. So this story is going to be told to us by Lord Nityananda. Because Lord Nityananda, before he came to meet Lord Chaitanya, Lord Nityananda had traveled around India, all the holy places. He traveled with a sannyasi. So he came to see this deity called Sakshi Gopal. Sakshi means the witness. So Nityananda Prabhu, he had heard the story from the local people when he was traveling around. The local people, they told him about the deity, the pastimes of the deity. At this time, the deity, at the time of Lord Chaitanya and Lord Nityananda, the deity was still in the town of Cuttack, but later on, then the deity was moved nearer to the Jagannath temple. At one point they brought the deity into the temple. The deity of Gopal, Sakshi Gopal, was brought into the Jagannath temple and he was staying in the Jagannath temple. But then there was some disagreement between the two deities, Sakshi Gopal and Jagannath. They had some quarrel, and so they had to bring Gopal out, and they put a new temple. They built him a temple near to Jagannath Puri, but not in Jagannath Puri.
但是在这两个神像之间，主加格纳塔和那些勾塔，这两个神像之间有一些分歧，有一些争吵。后来，所以不得把这个萨西勾塔神像又给他转了，建了一个新的庙，在加格纳塔，不是加格纳塔，但是离那很近的一个地方。
Just like at our Jagannath Mandir in Rajpur here in Mayapur, there's Jagannath there. And when they put the Govardhan there, then there was some problem because Jagannath was saying this Govardhan Shila is eating all the offering. The Pujari had a dream, and in the dream Jagannath was complaining that this Govardhan Shila is eating all the offering.
Yeah, just like we in Mayapur's
Gurudan Shiva那个神像，那个在那儿的时候，加纳纳的发现这个Gurudan Shiva神像把所有的供奉全是掉了，然后他就Pujari就在那梦中，然后听到那个加纳纳的Pujari报怨说，Gurudan Shiva这个神像吃了所有的供奉。 So then they decide, okay, we have to make a separate offering plate for the Govardhan Shila and a separate plate for Jagannath. So sometimes the deities, they have problems. Okay, so the story about the Shakshi Gopal, how he became a witness, it tells about there were two brahmanas who were going to visit different holy places. One was a young man and the other was an elderly man. So the young man was helping the old man to go to all the places. So they were both from South India, and they came up and they went first to Gaya, then they went to Kasi, then they went to Prayag. Kasi. And then finally they came to Mathura. And they started to visit the 12 different forests of Vrindavan. And they went to Govardhan Hill, and they went round the Govardhan Hill. Then they came to the town of Vrindavan. So there's a place where there's a, in the village of Vrindavan, there's a Govinda temple. But they were worshipping Gopal. And so they took bath in all the different places. There's many bathing places where you're supposed to take bath when you go on parikrama around Vrindavan. They took a special in the river Yamuna. You go to Kesigat and have a bath there at Kesigat. Take bath there at the Kesigat. And then also go to Kaliagat and take bath there at Kaliagat. It's very hot, very dry in Vrindavan. So it's nice to take bath in the Yamuna River and get refreshed. So I feel very happy to go and take bath, go in the river. And then when they came to see the deity Gopal, then they were so happy, they thought, oh, such a beautiful deity, that they stayed there for 4 days. So the old man was very happy, satisfied with the help he was getting from the young man. And the old man was telling the young man that it's only by your kindness that I'm able to visit all these places. He said, my own son, he doesn't come, he doesn't help me do this. But you're so kind that I'm not even feeling tired while I'm going on this parikrama with you. So he said, I want to show my gratitude to you. So I promise you to give you my daughter in charity. In other words, you know, you take my daughter for a wife, you can marry my daughter, she can be your wife. But the young man said, oh, please don't speak like this. This can be very dangerous for you, that this is very unusual. Because, you know, you're an aristocratic man, you're the high class family, and you're educated and you're wealthy, but I'm not, I'm none of these things. Now, for marriage purposes, usually the family are very careful to select. You know, the man should be equal to the woman. They should be at least equal in wealth and education and culture. People, when they marry their daughters, when they arrange their daughter's marriage, they want to make sure that the daughter will have good children. So they want to find a man who is suitably qualified to have good children. At least in the past, it was not, people did not marry on, they did not marry on the basis of physical attraction, what we would call a love marriage. Yeah, we would call this a love marriage, or we may even call it a lust marriage, not love, but lust. So in the past, at least in India, the culture was the parents, the family would arrange the daughter's marriage to a suitable man who had to be qualified. We can see in America now, in the USA at least, there's many women there, highly educated. You know, they go on for postgraduate courses and so on. But when they come to find a man, to find a man who's also educated like that, very difficult. And many of them, they just have to marry a man who's not educated at all. who didn't even study at university. So this young man says to the old man, I'm not a suitable husband for your daughter. I'm not on her level. My only purpose in serving you was to please Krishna. I did it as a service to Krishna because you are also Krishna's devotee. And you're also a Brahmana, and I know Lord Krishna is very pleased when we serve the Brahmanas. And when Lord Krishna is pleased, then our devotional service will also improve a lot. But the old man said, oh, he said, don't worry, I will give you my daughter. I have already decided this. You don't worry about anything. But the young man, he's also a Brahmana, but he's not educated, he's not rich, he's just a very poor Brahmana. So he said, the young man says to the old man, he said, your family, your wife and your sons and all your relatives, they will be very upset with you if you say like this to them. And the young man tells about Rukmini, how Rukmini also wanted to marry Krishna, and her father, Maharaj Bhishmaka, he wanted his daughter to marry Krishna. But her brothers, her brothers didn't want their sister to marry Krishna. They arranged their sister's marriage to Sishupa. So there was a big fight. Krishna had to come and he had to steal Rukmini. But finally, Krishna defeated Rukmini's brothers, and he took Rukmini with him to Dwarka for his first wife. So the old man says, my daughter is my property. If I choose to give her to you, nobody can stop me.
Mm-hmm.
So he said, you don't have to have any doubt about this. You just agree what I'm saying.
他就告诉给年轻人说，他说你对此不必有任何的疑惑，然后你只要接受我该说的就行了。
So the young Brahmana says, all right, if you really can, if you're serious about this, he said, then let's go in front of Gopal, in front of the deity Gopal, and you tell there, in front of Gopal, let Gopal hear your promise.
如果你已经这么决定的话，那好吧，那我们去到勾帕神像的面前，你在勾帕神像面前，然后，这么去说。
So they came in front of the deity, and the old man said to Gopal, he said, please witness, you be the witness that I am giving my daughter to this boy.
然后他们就来到哥帕神像面前，这个老年人就说，也对这个哥帕神像说，他说请见证，现在我要把我的这个，我把我的女儿，嫁给这个年轻人。And
the young boy also spoke to the deity and said, my dear Lord, you are my witness. If I have any problem with this later on, I may have to come to you to be the witness to prove it, what has been said.
然后这年轻人也对哥帕神像说，他说：“我亲爱的主啊，然后现在你要做我的见证人。如果将来在这件事情上有任何的问题的话，我要让你来做我的见证人。”
So like these people, when they had some, when they want to make some promise, they'll go in front of the deity. Just like when we take initiation, we make our vows in front of the deity. The deity is the witness.
所以就像在发下誓言的时候，人们都会来到神像面前。就像我们在接受起义的时候，我们在神像面前，在神像面前发下起义的誓言。
And sometimes also after a marriage, then the couple will also go in front of the deity, and they will exchange garlands with each other, and in this way, they're recognizing each other as in a marital relationship.
所以在结婚的时候，像夫妻，他们也是会来到神像面前，然后在神像面前交换花环，然后这样举行婚礼。So
the deity is very important in the society for people and family and so on. If there's any dispute, then they come to the deity.
也是神像在社会中是非常重要的。
So the two brahmanas, they made their promise. The old man made his promise in front of the deity, and then they went home.
然后这两个brahmana，这两个婆罗门呢，那个老年人他就在那个神像面前发下了誓言。 做出了承诺,
and the young man was serving the old man just like the old man was his guru. So when they got home, after some time, the old man became a He became nervous, and he remembered what he had promised to the young man. Because he knows, I made my promise in a holy place, in front of the deity. I have to keep my promise.
他说我在圣地，在神像的面前做出了一个承诺，所以我必须要履行我的承诺。So
the old man called all of his family and relatives and friends. He called them all to come, and then he announced to them what happened.
然后这个老年人呢，就把他的家人，把他的所有的家人都召集起来，然后向他们宣布，发生了什么。
He told them how he promised the young man that he could marry his daughter.
他告诉他的亲人们说，他已经承诺这个年轻人可以娶他们的女儿。
So when the family heard this, they were all shocked. They said, "Oh no, cannot."
然后当他家人听到这个消息的时候，他们都震惊了，他们就大声喊道，就是不行，不行。
The wife said, "If you give our daughter to this man, I will die. I'll kill myself."
他妻子就说，如果你把我们的女儿给这个年轻人的话，嫁给这个年轻人的话，我会死的，我会自杀的。
We will lose our position in society if we give our daughter to this low class man.
如果我们把我们女儿嫁给这个低阶层的人的话，我们就在社会上就是丧失我们的地位。
And people will joke about us and make fool of us. But the old man said, "Well, look, I've made a promise. I was in the pip on the holy place, and I made the promise." So, the family all said, "If you give your daughter away like this."We don't want anything more to do with you. And his wife and son said, "And we will take poison and die." And so the old man said, "Well, the young man,will ask Gopal as a witness." And so this, when it, if the, go, the deity comes as a witness, then you have to give the daughter. So the man's family, this old man's family, they're not very devoted people, and they don't understand the nature of the deity. So the old man's son said,So the deity may be the witness, but the deity is far away. How can he come here? So you just have to say that you don't remember what you said.You don't need to lie, just say you don't remember what you said. And the young man's son said, "I will take care of everything. I know how to deal with this man. I can argue with him."So the old man was helpless, he didn't know what to do. He just tried to pray to Gopal. He prayed to Gopal, I just want you to help me to keep my religious principles. I don't want to be a liar, I don't want to break my promise.But at the same time, my family members are dying and they feel so bad about it. I don't want them to all die.
But at the same time, my family members are dying and they feel so bad about it.
So then the next day, the young man came to the old man's house and he said, you promised to give your daughter in charity to me.
第二天这个年轻人就来到了老男人的家里，告诉他，提醒他说，你曾经承诺要把你的女儿嫁给我。
But now you're not saying anything. So what's happening?
但是你现在什么都没有说，到底发生了什么事？
So the old man, he didn't know what to say, didn't say anything.
这个老年人他不知道该说什么，所以他就什么都没说。
But then the young man's son came and he had a stick and he was going to beat the young man, the young brahmana.
然后这个老年人的儿子当时就拿了棍子就出来了，他也想要来试图打这个年轻人。
He said, "You're a rascal. How can you marry my sister?"
你这个混账，你怎么能嫁，能够娶我的妹妹呢？
You are not at all qualified to be a suitable husband for my sister.
你根本就配不上我的妹妹，不配做我妹妹的丈夫。
So when he saw the young man with the stick, the other brahmana, he ran away. But the next day he came back. He came back with all the people from the village.
然后，但第二天呢，他就又逛又回来了。他带了村里所有人一起给他来了。
The young brahmana had told all the people in the village what happened, so they all came to see the old brahmana and to ask him if it was true.
因为这个年轻人，你告诉村子的人说这个发生了什么，然后所以村子的人都过来看这个老年人他到底怎么回事。
So all the people asked the old brahmana, "Did you promise like this? Did you promise to give your daughter in charity?"
然后村里人就问这个老道们说，你是不是说了，是不是做出承诺要把你的女儿嫁给这个年轻人呢？
Why are you not keeping your promise? If you give your word, you should keep your promise.
如果你发出了誓言，做出了承诺，你就应该履行自己的承诺。
So the old brahmana says, I don't remember what happened. I don't remember making a promise like that.
然后这个老年人就说，我不记得我曾经做出那个承诺，我不记得了。
So then the old brahmana's son, who is not a devotee, he came and he began to speak.
然后这个老人的儿子，他就，因为他不是贡献的，然后他就开始说话了。And he said,
"My father went to visit the holy places, and he took money with him, and this young man saw my father's money, and he stole it all from him."
然后他说，我父亲去朝圣的时候啊，带了很多的钱。这个年轻人他看到我父亲的钱，然后就偷了我父亲的钱。And
then he gave some intoxication to my father and made my father mad.
他给我父亲一些麻醉品，然后让我父亲像发疯了一样。So
he took all my father's money and then he claimed that my father promised to give him his daughter in charity.
然后他就拿走父亲所有的钱，而且是声称我父亲向他承诺要把女儿嫁给他。So
just you can, and the young man said to all the people, he said, "Do you really think that this man is a suitable match for my daughter, for my sister?"
然后这年轻人就说，向所有村的人说。 你们觉得这个年轻人是我妹妹的合适的，就是丈夫的人选吗？
So all the people, of course, they knew that this old man, his family is high class, and the young man, the young brahmana, he is just a very poor family and no education and no money. So they agreed, you know, not a very good match, not very.
村里人他知道这个就是这个老人还有他的儿子，他们都是很高阶层的人，然后是很著名门外望族。但是这个年轻人呢，没有受过很好的教育，也不富有，所以其实并不是门当户对的。
So then the young Brahmana spoke. He said, this man's son is just speaking like this. He's lying. He just wants to try to prove, to get victory, and he's telling all these lies. It's never happened like that.
然后这年轻人就说：“这个老人的儿子他在撒谎，他其实是事情的事发生不是这样子的。”然后他就讲了事情的经过。
The old man was very satisfied with everything I did for him. I took care of him all the time, and he was very happy with my service.
然后，因为我一直在照顾这个老人，所以他对我的服务非常的满意。
And I told him I was not a fit husband for his daughter, but he insisted.
但我曾经告诉他，我不是他女儿的合适的丈夫人选，但是他却坚持要把女儿嫁给我。
And again, he said, "I'm giving you my daughter. You accept her."
他告诉我，我现在把女儿给你，你接受就好。
I told him his family and friends would never agree, but he said, "No, it's my, she's my daughter. I can give you my daughter."
即便我的家人不同意，但是这是我的女儿。
And the young Brahmana said, "I'm worried that you'll be able to keep your promise. If you don't keep your promise, it will be very bad for you."
然后对年轻人就说。你没法履行你的承诺了。如果你没法履行你的承诺，那对你是不好的。
But the old man said, "No, I'm giving you. You must take her."
但是这个老人坚持说，我一定要把女儿给你，你一定要接受。
And so we both went in front of the Gopal deity, and we made it. And in front of the Gopal deity, he heard everything. He heard the Brahmana's promise to give the daughter to me in charity.
所以我们两个就来到了神像面前，在神像面前，他承诺要把女儿嫁给我。
So at that time, I told the Gopal deity that if there's any problem, I will ask you to be the witness.
然后当时我就在那个高挂神像说，就是如果有任何的问题发生的话，我就会来请你做我的见证人。
So everybody accepts the words of the Supreme Lord, because the deity is the Supreme Lord. So whatever the Supreme Lord says, that's the final word. Nobody can argue with that.
所以每个人都会接受至尊主所说的话。所以神像和至尊主是没有区别，至神像就是至尊主。所以没有人会，就每个人都会接受他说的话。
So then the old man. He said, "Yes, this is true." Actually, he said, "This actually it happened like that." He said, "If Gopal comes here as a witness, I will certainly give my daughter to the young man."
这时候，这个老人就说：“事情的发生确实是这样的。如果 Gopal 神像来做证明的话，我肯定会把我的女儿嫁给这个年轻人。”
So then, the young man, the old man, the old Brahmana's son. He said, "Yes, this is a very good settlement. This is a good agreement. Let Gopal come here and be the witness."
Oh, this old man's son said, "This agreement is very good. This settlement is very good. Let Gopal come here
and be the witness." And the old man thought that Lord Krishna is very merciful. If he want, he can certainly come to prove that we made the promise.
对，所以这个老人就想，至尊主 Krishna 他是很仁慈的，如果他愿意的话，他肯定来，能来证明这件事情，他曾经做过这个承诺。
And the young, the old man's son, who's an atheist, he thought, yeah, let Gopal come. He thought, of course, the deity is not going to come here. How is it possible the deity could come here?
这个他的儿子嘛，这老人的儿子，他是无神论的，所以他就想，
So everything was written down, the agreement was written down on paper, and they wrote it in so that everybody knew what was going to supposed to happen, and nobody could argue anymore about it. So they wrote down in the paper that Gopal will come and be the witness. And so the old man, he was truthful, but he was just in a difficult situation because of the problem of his family. He didn't want to break his promise, but he just didn't want his family all to die. So the young man thought, yeah, I will go back to Vrindavan. I will go back and ask Gopal to come and be the witness. So the young man went back to Vrindavan on his own this time, and he went back to see the deity, and he came, got to Vrindavan, went to the deity Gopal and offered his obeisances and told everything to the deity. So he spoke to the deity, just like we would speak to a person. He spoke to the deity. He said, you have to protect Brahminical culture, and you are very merciful. He said, I don't want to get this girl for a bride just for some sense gratification, but I want to keep the Brahmana's promise. If this Brahmana doesn't keep his promise, then it's very painful for me, because he promised me. So if he doesn't keep his promise, it will be very bad for him. The young Brahmana was a very pure devotee. He didn't want sense gratification. He just wanted to serve Krishna. And the old Brahmana was also a devotee, very devoted to Krishna. So the young man spoke to the deity and said, so I want you to come as a witness that you're the only one, you know everything, you should, we need you to come. If you don't come to testify, to be the witness, then you become guilty of sin, because you know what happened, and it will be sinful on your part if you don't come to be the witness. So the deity said to the man, he said, okay, my Brahman, he said, what you do, he said, you go home and then call a meeting of all the men, and in that meeting, you just remember me. Harry Bob, something wrong with your mic. Harry Bob?
Sarah Dira, 你的网络有问题，要不然那Toshiko Pina的你接着跟Guru翻译。你那还没恢复，Sarah Dira。Toshiko Pina的你同时把麦打开吧，你们两个，要是他的网络不行的时候，你就补充一下。
Are we ready?
Okay, Guru Maharaj, you can continue.
Okay. So, Krishna is instructing, the deity Gopal is speaking to the young Brahmana. In Vrindavan.
这个在文达文这个神像，Gopa神像呢，就对这个年轻的 Brahmana 做了一个训示。
Right, because the young Brahmana had come there to Vrindavan, and he came to ask the deity to come and be the witness.
因为呢，这个年轻的 Brahmana 呢，他一直来到了文达文。
So the deity said, what you do, he said, you go back, and then you just when you go back there, you just think of me, and then I will come. But the young man was not satisfied.
但是呢，这个年轻的Brahmana对神像的这番话并不满足。
He said, "No. He said, if you come there in as the four-hand Vishnu form, nobody will believe you."
他说呢，即便你以这个侍婢的威士奴形体显现在那里，但是没有人会相信你。
You have to come as Gopal. You have to come in this form now. You have to come as you are.
你现在要以你的这个Gopa的形体去到那里，以你现在的这个形象去到那里。
And then when people see you in that form, then they will accept.
如果人们看到了你现在的这个Gopa的形体的话，他们才会相信。
But Gopal said, well, look, I'm a deity. I can't go walking from one place to another. So the Brahmana said, well, you're speaking to me. Why can you not walk?
The 年轻的 Brahmana 就说呢, 既然你都可以, 向我说话，那你为什么不能走路呢？
You're not a statue. You're the son of Nanda Maharaj.
您根本不是一尊雕像，您就是 Nanda Maharaj 的儿子。
So for the sake of this old Brahmana, you have to do what you never did before. You have to come there.
所以呢，为了这个年迈的 Brahmana 的缘故呢，你得做一些您从来没有做过的事情。
So the deity was defeated. So the deity said, okay, I will walk behind you. You walk and I will just walk behind you.
所以呢，这个神像就同意了。嗯，好吧，那我会跟在你后面走，你在前面走，我在后面跟着你。
So the deity actually walked. Said they walked for 100 days to get back to their place.
所以这个神像呢，就一直就跟着走。他实际上他走了100天。
So.We should understand the deity in the temple is not a statue. It may be made of material elements, but it's not a statue.
所以呢，我们应该知道这个庙宇里的神像，它不是一个雕塑。虽然它是用物质元素来做成的，但是呢，它不是一个雕塑。
Although just like the deity of Gopal appeared to be stone, but it was not stone.He's the son of Nanda Maharaj.
就好比这个欧巴的神像看起来是一个石头，但实际上他不是石头，他直接是 Nanda Maharaj 的儿子。
And the deity can behave just like Krishna himself. He can walk, he can talk, he can do everything.
所以这个神像呢，就和 Krishna 本身是一个。
So.So this way, the deity told the young Brahmana, he said, don't try to see me, don't turn around, you just walk, and you will hear my ankle bells. You will know that I'm following.
这个神像呢，就对这个年轻的 Brahmana 就说道，你不要转过身来，试图来看我。我会一直跟在你后面，你听到我的这个脚铃的声音，你就会知道我在后面跟着你。
But if you turn and look at me, then I'll stay in that place. I won't move anymore.
但是如果你转过身来看我的话，我就会待在原地不动，我就不会再往前走了。
And every day you have to cook 1 kilo of rice and offer it to me, and I will eat that rice and follow behind you.
你每天呢要烹饪1公斤的米饭，然后供奉给我吃，我就吃这个米饭，然后跟着你走。
So the next day, the Brahmana took permission from Gopal and began to walk, and Gopal followed.
第二天呢，这个年轻的 Brahmana 他就祈求得到 Gopal 的允许，开始启程，前往他自己的国家，然后 Gopal 就跟在他后面。
And the young Brahmana could hear the ankle bells behind him. He was very happy. And every day he would cook rice and Gopal would eat.
This young Brahmana, he heard his ding-dong bell behind him. He felt very happy. Every day he would offer Gopal rice.
And then gradually, after about 100 days, he came back to his own village.
在100天之后呢，他们就终于来到了，他自己的村庄。
So he was thinking, I have to go and tell all the people that the witness has come.
他就在想呢，现在，我要去告诉每一个人，我的见证人已经到了。
He thought if they didn't see the Gopal deity, they would not believe him.
如果他们没有看到这个 Gopal 的神像的话，他们是不会相信的。
But even if Gopal stays now where we are, no harm. It's near to my village.
但 是如果 Gopa 就留在现在这个地方的话也没关系，因为这个地方离我的这个村庄已经很近了。
So he turned around, he looked back, and he saw the deity was standing there smiling.
所以呢，他想到这里，他就转过身看了这个神像，他就看到这个神像 Gopa 就站在那里。
So,
站在那里微笑。
And the deity said to the Brahmin, he said, okay. He said, I will stay here, I'm not going to leave. You go to your home and tell the people. And the boy, young man, went to the top village, told everybody Gopal has come.People were amazed, they were so surprised. Oh, Gopal has actually come. They all came to see Gopal. And when the people saw the beauty, how Gopal was so beautiful,And they heard how Gopal had walked all the way there. They were so surprised. And the old Brahmana came and he came and also fell in front of Gopal. He's so happy.
这个年老的 Brahma 呢，听说这一消息呢，他也前来看这个 Gopa 的神像，他向 Gopa 神像致以礼拜，他感到非常的高兴。
So then all the town people came, and Gopal was the witness that he'd seen the Brahmana promise to give his daughter to the young Brahmana.
所以呢，这个就当着村庄里所有人的面呢，这个主 Gopa 就作证，这个年老的 Brahma 呢。把他的女儿布施给了这位年轻的 Brahmana。
So after the marriage was performed, then the deity told the Brahmanas, those the young Brahmana and the old Brahmana, he said, "You two Brahmanas are my eternal servants, birth after birth."
在这个婚礼举行之后呢，这个神像就对两位 Brahmana 说，你们两个 Brahmana 真真实实都是我永恒的仆人。
Yeah, they were Nitya Siddha devotees, they were eternal devotees. So they were never conditioned. And you can see, although they're both Nitya Siddhas, one was materially opulent and the other was not. But they're both Nitya Siddhas.
他们两个人都是尼卡西达，都是永恒完美的奉献者。但是呢，其中一个在物质上很富有，但是另外一个就很贫穷。
So the Lord told that the deity told them, "I have become very pleased by your truthfulness. It's very good that you're both so truthful." He said, "Now you can ask a benediction."
这个神像就对这两位 Brahman 呢说到呢，我对你们两个人的这个真诚感到非常的满意，你们都很诚实，所以现在你们可以向我要一个祝福。
So the Brahmanas begged the deity, said, "Please stay here, so that people all over the world will know how you are very merciful to your servants."
然后这两位 Brahman 呢就说呢，请您留在这里。这样的话，全世界的人们都将知道您对您的仆人有多么仁慈。
So Gopal agreed. He stayed there, and the two Brahmanas became his servants. And many people would come to see the deity.
所以说呢，就这样，主 Gopa 就留了下来。然后这两个 Brahman 呢，就服务这个神像。当人们听说。
And even the king heard about the story, and he also came to see the deity, and he was very happy. And he built a big temple for the deity.
甚至这个国家的国王听说了这个故事之后呢，他都感到非常的高兴，于是为这个神像建了一个很好的庙宇。
So the deity stayed there in that place for a long time.
所以这个神像呢，就在那里留了很长的一段时间。
But then there was a fight between another king, the king of Puri and this king, and they had a fight. And the king of Puri won, and he took that deity of Gopal and he brought it to Puri.
后来呢，就发生了一场战争，就是这个 Puri 的国王他赢得了这个战争，所以呢，他就把这个神像转移到了这个 Puri。
So the king of Puri, he's a great devotee, so he was happy to get the deity of Gopal. He asked the deity of Gopal, please come to my kingdom. So he brought Gopal to Puri.
Puri 的这个国王呢是一名奉献者，他就很喜欢这个神像，他就想把这个神像请到他自己的国家。
So they had the worship of the Gopal deity going on. They put the deity was put in, then put in the other town of Cuttack.
所以呢，他们就开始崇拜这个神像。他们把这个神像安置在了 Cuttack 这个地方。
And the queen of Puri, she went to see the deity of Gopal, and she brought many ornaments to give to the deity.
这个国王的这个妻子，那个王后呢，她也去卡塔卡去看这个神像，并且呢为这个神像带了很多的金银首饰。
And she had a very valuable pearl, and she wanted to give it to the deity for a nose ring.
这个王后呢有一颗非常珍贵的这个珍珠，她想就把这个珍珠送给波法神像。
And she thought, if there's a hole in the deity's nose, then I could put the pearl there. It would be good to give to the deity.
这个王后就在想呢，如果这个神像的鼻子上有一个洞的话，我就可以把这个珍珠送给他了。这样的话会很美。
So in her dream, when that night, in the queen, when she had a dream, in the dream, Gopal spoke to her and told her, said, when I was a child, my mother made a hole in my nose.And you can put your pearl there.
在当天晚上呢，这个王后就做了一个梦，在梦里面 ，Gopa 就对她说了一番话。她说到呢，在我小时候的时候，我母亲在我鼻子上弄了一个洞，你可以在那里安放一颗珍珠。
So the next day, the king went with the queen, and they brought the pearl. They went to see the deity, and they saw there was a hole in the nose of the deity, and they put the pearl there.
所以第二天呢，这个国王和王后就一起去看这个神像。他们看到这个神像的鼻子上有一个洞，所以他们就在这个就给神像带了一颗珍珠。
So this story was all told by Lord Nityananda, and Lord Chaitanya is very happy to hear about this wedding. Now.
这个故事呢是由主尼塔南达法布所讲述的。就塔塔亚听到这个故事的时候，他感到非常的高兴。他聆听到这个Gopa见证婚礼的这个故事，感到非常的高兴。
Lord Chaitanya is a sannyasi, but still he's happy to hear this about the marriage. He's happy to hear the story of the wedding.
虽然塔塔亚是一个 sannyasi, 是一个托钵僧，但是呢。他听说这个婚礼的故事的时候，也感到非常的高兴。
Because this wedding is not any, it's not just some karma kandi, it's not just some material ritualistic wedding for sense gratification, some man or woman, but it's a very spiritual, religious ceremony.
这个婚礼呢，它并不是属于 karma kanda, 就是说。有男女之间的这种感官享乐的这种婚礼，而是它是一种灵性的宗教仪式。
Yeah, usually if there's a wedding, you know, We'll think, oh no, I don't want to go there, I don't want to be at the wedding, because it's just all sense gratification, and people eat a lot, and they joke a lot, and it's not very nice association, not very spiritual atmosphere.
有的时候呢，就是如果别人，就邀请我们去参加婚礼的话，有的时候我们不想去参加，因为我们会觉得那只不过是一些旁观享乐，人们在那里吃吃喝喝、相互打趣啊，都是一些物质的活动，没有什么灵性的氛围。
But we see this wedding, Lord Chaitanya, he's sitting hearing Lord Nityananda tell the story. He's very happy to hear the pastime because it's a very spiritual story.
但是呢，在这里我们看到这个主塔坦亚非常高兴的在聆听主尼卡兰达法布讲述这个婚礼的故事，因为这一个故事呢是灵性的。
It's nothing. Yeah, the marriage of the man giving his daughter in marriage is not material. It's a spiritual activity. The man wants to keep his religious principles.
这个年老的布拉玛纳呢，想要把他的女儿就是嫁给这个年轻的布拉玛纳，实际上这并不是物质的活动，而是灵性的一个宗教性的这个活动。
And we see how much.
是符合宗教原则的活动。We
see how Lord Krishna, in the form of the deity, how much he is concerned for the brahmanas to keep their truthfulness.
我们看到这个 Krishna， 他作为 Gopa 神像的这个形制，他非常的在意如何能够保证这个 Brahma 呢能够信守他们的宗教的这个誓言。
So much so that the deity came walking 100 days.
这个神像的 Gopa 神像，他是如此的在意，以至于他走了100天。 来跟着这个Brahmana来到他的村庄。Okay,
are there any questions?
看大家现在有什么问题吗？
Anybody has any questions?
Yes, there are questions.
Okay.
Subhuti Roy, Pabu Wen, Dingbai Guru Maharaj, Dingbai Fan Yi, Fung Sen Zhe Men, Wen Ti Yi, Ji Shi Zai Mung Zhong Jian Dao Zhu De Xian Xian, Zhe Shi Bu Shi Yi Wei Zhe, Zhe Wei Ji Shi Yi Jing Da Dao Mou Zhong Cheng Du De Wan Mei. The first question is from Subhuti Roy, Pabu, that the Pujari saying the Lord's appearance in his dream. Does that mean that this Pujari has achieved some degree of perfection?
Which Pujari?
The Pujari who dreamed the Lord in his dream.
Oh, that's about yesterday's story, right?
Subhuti Prabhu, 您指的是昨天的那个祭司吗？ 在梦中见到主的显现呢？
Anyway, yeah, if the Pujari dreams about Krishna, yeah, it means Pujari is a very advanced devotee, pure devotee.
是的，如果这个Pujari能够梦见主的话， 他说明他是一个很进步的奉献者，他是纯粹的。
Krishna was coming in his dream and instructing him.
Krishna 呢，来到他的梦中，然后在梦中训斥他。
Yeah, we heard yesterday how the Pujari had the dream that Krishna had stolen the pot of milk. So the Pujari got up and took a bath and then went into the altar and found the pot. And then he wiped the floor and then he came out.
昨天我们听到了这个神像呢，在这个普加瑞的梦中显现，然后这个普加瑞醒来之后呢，他就沐浴，然后进入到神像房，拿出了这个甜奶饭的罐子。
And today we're hearing about the two brahmanas, the young and the old brahmana, and how they speak to the deity, and how they come and talk to the deity and make their promise in front of the deity.
然后今天呢，我们也听说了这两位brahmana，他们向这个在神像面前举下承诺，而且呢，他们在跟神像进行这个对话。
So when we do initiations, we like to have deities also present, and you make your vow in front of the deities.
对，当我们启迪的时候呢，最好这个有神像在这个现场做这个见证，我们会在这个神像面前发下誓言。
Deity is a witness.
这个神像作为见证人。
If you don't chant your rounds, we'll have Krishna come as a witness to say you
promised.
Okay, any other question?
Yes. 在圣地的显得很信心坚定，但是回到家中之后却难以持。是不是因为过于热心？对于我而言，是否应该小心在圣地许下一些有点做到的承诺？如果许下一些承诺，如何长时间维系自己的承诺 ？So the second question is, the old brahmana is confident, make promise in inland. But when he comes to home, he cannot persist his promise. Is that because he is too much enthusiastic? For us, shall we be careful that the promise we make in the Holy Land, if we make some vows, how to keep our vows for a long time?
Well, if you make a vow, you should be able to keep it. Don't make a vow unless you can keep it.
这个，如果你许下一些承诺的话，这个承诺一定是你能够去兑现的。如果不能够兑现的话，你最好别许下这样的承诺。You
want to make the vow? It's for lifetime. It's not just for a short time. It's for life.
而且你许下的这个承诺呢，应该是你终身要去遵守的承诺，而不是说仅仅这一个短暂的。Yeah,
I remember one devotee was getting initiation, and they came and they brought very nice beads. I said, "Oh, these are very nice beads," and they said, "Yes, well, these are for life. I'm going to be using them for the rest of my life, so I want to have nice beads to chant."
嗯 ，Sorry, I didn't get.
One devotee came with very nice beads at the time of their initiation.
Okay, 就是有一个奉献者，他在启迪的时候呢，他就得到一串很好的念珠。
So I said, "Oh, these beads are very nice," and they said, "Yes, well, I'm going to use them for the rest of my life. Every day I have to chant."
然后呢，他们说这个，他就说呢，这个念珠是非常好的念珠，我的余生的每一天呢，我都要用这个念珠来念诵。
So this is right. We make a vow; it's for life.
所以这是正确的。我们发下的这个誓言，我们的这个承诺是终其一生的。
Okay, any other question?
Yes. Panchadadava Prabhu asked, 非常孤鲁奉献者，哪种级别的奉献者可以和神像交流说话？ So the question is from Panchadadava Prabhu. which level of devotee can speak to the deity directly?
Every devotee can speak to the deity directly.
每一位奉献者都可以直接和神像说话交流。
Deity is there for us to speak to him. Maybe we should speak to him.
神像在那里，我们就是可以和他说话的，可以和他去进行交流的。
When I was a new devotee, I remember I joined the movement. We had deities. We had the deity, and we had every Sunday. Every devotee had to take turns to sit in front of the deity and talk to the deity and tell the deity what service we're doing, what make a report.
就是我记得，当我还是一个新奉献者的时候呢。我刚加入这个非常自觉运动的时候呢，我们有一个神像，然后每到周日的时候呢，我们这些奉献者就会轮流的来到神像面前去和神像说话，就是向神像汇报一些我们做了怎么样的服务，就是这样向神像汇报。
So there's no restriction about who can talk to the deities. Everyone can talk to the deities.
所以没有这样的限制，不是说只有谁才可以跟神像说话，每个人都可以跟神像说话。
Any other question?
Yes. Krishna Balarama Das, 请拜 Guru Maharaj, 我们无法兑现对奉献者的承诺，我们不能兑现对灵性导师的承诺。我们不能兑现对神像的誓言，该怎么办？Obeisances to Guru Maharaj. We cannot keep our promise to the devotees, cannot keep our promise to the spiritual master, cannot keep our vows to the deities. What shall I do?
Well, we have to try harder.Keep trying.
所以你要更加的努力，你要继续努力。
Don't give up.
不要放弃。
You can do it. If you just keep trying, Krishna will give you the ability.
所以，只要你一直不断的去努力的话，你 Krishna 会给你这个能力，你只需要继续做。
We say failure is the pillar of success. I don't know if you can translate it.
我们中国有句古话，失败是成功之母。
So we have to keep trying. You know, all devotees, we all have these challenges in our devotional service.
所以呢，我们要继续不断的努力。我们知道，我们所有的奉献者在我们的奉献服务当中都会多多少少的遇到挑战。
But we hope that gradually you can become more successful and you can do better. In the beginning, it's difficult.
但是呢，我们希望就是逐渐的，你会取得成功，你会做得越来越好。在刚开始的时候，虽然有一点困难。
But Krishna is very merciful. We have to take help from Krishna.
但是 Krishna 是非常仁慈的，我们要信守我们对 Krishna 的承诺。
We should regret.That we're very fallen.
We should regret.
And we should pray that we can give up this fallen condition, make some spiritual progress.
然后呢，我们就像 Krishna 祈祷，我们可以放弃我们这种堕落的状态，然后在宁静的生活当中取得进步。
Mm-hmm.
Krishna Balaram Das is saying thank you, Maharaj.
Okay, any other question?
Mm. 大 家还有其他的问题吗？No questions.
No more questions?
No more.
Okay, so we'll just continue. There's just a little bit more in this chapter. We can just go on for a little bit, right?
然后关于这个章节，我们可以继续再多讲一些。
So Lord Chaitanya was sitting there in front of the Gopal deity, and the devotees could see that Lord Chaitanya and the deity of Gopal, they were actually the same.
主查塔亚马哈帕布坐在戈帕神像面前，所有的奉献者们看到主查塔亚马哈帕布和戈帕神像实际上是一个人。
They both had the same complexion, the golden color.
他们有着同样的肤色，他们的肤色都是金黄色的。
And they had big, powerful bodies, strong bodies.
他们都拥有强健的身体。
And they were both dressed in the saffron cloth.
他们两个人都穿着藏红花色的衣服。
And they all, both had eyes.Lotus eyes, and they were effulgent.
他们两个人都有着莲花般的眼睛，而且都散发出辉煌的光彩。
And both their faces were like the moon.
他们两个人的脸都好似满月一般。
So Lord Nityananda, he saw.How Lord Chaitanya looked like the Gopal deity, he began to smile, seeing the similarity.
当尼加兰达帕布看到这个勾帕神像和主财泰亚马哈帕布极为相似的这个时候，他就开始微笑了。
So then they're on their way to go to Jagannath Puri. They come to Bhubaneswar.
在他们前往这个加格纳普瑞的路程当中，在中途他们来到了布巴内斯瓦。
And they came to the place where there's some river, and Lord Chaitanya had given his sannyasi rod, the danda, to Lord Nityananda to carry for him.
然后呢，他们就来到了一条河边，在这里呢，主查塔亚把他的三亚喜棍交给了主尼塔兰达。
Lord Chaitanya went to see the temple of Lord Shiva, and Lord Nityananda was carrying the sannyasi rod of Lord Chaitanya, and Lord Chaitanya had gone inside the Shiva temple at that time.Lord Nityananda broke the sannyasi rod into three pieces.
然后呢，这个主尼提兰达主塔塔亚马法布呢，他就去了这个主西瓦的庙宇。这个主尼提兰达呢，就拿着他的sannyasi棍。当这个主塔塔亚马法布去看这个西瓦庙的时候呢，这个尼提兰达就把他的sannyasi棍给摔成了三节。
So, when he broke it in three pieces, then Lord Nityananda threw the three pieces into the river that was there.
这个主尼提兰达呢，就把这个三亚喜棍折成了三节，然后扔到了这个河里面。
So why did Lord Nityananda break that sannyasi rod of Lord Chaitanya?
主尼提兰达为什么会把主财坦达的这个Sannyasi Kun 得成三节呢?
One thing is, Lord Chaitanya had taken sannyas in the line of the Mayavadi, in the line of Shankaracharya. So they give the Ekadanda, they only give one rod. Not like the Vaishnava, they have a Tridandi, they have three rods. But in the Lord Chaitanya, he took sannyas in the Mayavadi line, they only give one rod, Ekadanda. So he broke it into three to make it a tridandi.
其中一个原因呢，是因为主裁坦雅他接受萨尼亚西的时候，他是在玛雅瓦底，也就是香卡查亚的这个十部传记当中接受的萨尼亚西的启迪。那么在这个玛雅瓦底传记当中接受萨尼亚西启迪的时候呢，他得到的是 Eka Dandi， 也就是一个棍子，并不像 Vaisnava 中那样 ，Vaisnava 中它是三根棍子，所以说主。尼加曼塔呢就把这一根棍子折成了三节，这样的话就把它的这个一根棍子变成了三个棍子。
So the danda, the sannyasi rod is usually carried by the sannyasis who are on the beginning platform.
这个danda, 也就是这个 sannyasi 棍，通常是那些刚刚进阶 sannyasi 阶层的人所携带的。
But when they become Paramahamsa, when they become the topmost sannyasi, then they don't need the sannyasi rod.
但是呢，如果这个 sannyasi 他已经达到了 Paramahamsa 的层面的话，他就不再需要这个 sannyasi 棍了。
So Lord Nityananda, he didn't think Lord Chaitanya needed to have a sannyasi rod.
所以呢，这个主尼加南达不认为主财丹雅需要 sannyasi 棍。
Because he knows Lord Chaitanya is the Supreme Lord, Krishna. He doesn't need to take sannyas.
Sorry, I didn't get.
Lord Chaitanya is the Supreme Lord. He does not need to take sannyas.
主财丹雅他是至尊主 Krishna 本人，他并不需要当 sannyasi。
He did not think Lord Chaitanya has to wait to become a Paramahamsa.
这个主尼加南达并不觉得主查丹雅需要等待一段时间才能成为 Paramahamsa.
He thought Lord Chaitanya is already on the topmost platform.
他认为主查丹雅已经处在最高的层面了。
So he doesn't need to carry the sannyasi rod.
所以他根本不需要。拿着这个
三牙喜棍。So he broke it and threw it away.
所以尼加南达就把这个棍子折成了三节，然后扔进河里了。
So Lord Chaitanya didn't know immediately.
但是刚开始的时候的主查坦雅并不知道。
But after some time,Lord Chaitanya asked, "Where's my sannyasi rod?"
而是过了一会之后呢，这个主裁坦雅就问尼加南达，这个我的sannyasi棍在哪里？
They were having kirtan and they were dancing and chanting as they go along the road, walking to the temple of Jagannath Puri.
他们呢就一路唱着跳着，一路 kirtan 这样走向 Jagannath Puri。
Lord Chaitanya was feeling ecstasy. They could see the temple of Puri in the distance. They could see coming closer. So they were becoming more and more ecstatic.
这个主查坦雅呢，他正沉浸在这个狂喜当中。他从远处可以看到这个加格纳普瑞的那个庙宇。随着这个庙宇越来越近，他的狂喜也越来越增加了。
So at one point, then Lord Chaitanya came.Back to external consciousness, and he said, "Give me my danda, give me my sannyasi rod."
就这样走了一段时间之后呢，这个主查坦雅他好像恢复了外在的知觉，然后他就开始说，请把我的danda，请把我的这个sannyasi棍还给我。
So Lord Nityananda told him, "Oh, it's broken. It was broken into three pieces."
然后尼加南达卡布就回答说呢，你的三两喜棍已经被我折成三节了。
You don't remember? He said, "We were doing kirtan, and you jumped up, and you fell down, and I caught you, and we landed on the broke on the danda, and it broke."
他就说呢，反正你不记得了，就是我们在狂喜的 kirtan 的时候呢，我们一起摔倒在这个棍子上，把这个棍子压断了。
Yeah, our weight was too much for the danda, so it broke into pieces. I don't know where they are.
所以这个棍子呢，它已经摔成碎片了，我不知道它们现在在哪里。
And then Lord Nityananda said, "It's certainly my offense that is broken, so you can punish me as you like."
所以这个尼加南达跑步就说呢，一定是因为我的冒犯，所以你的棍子才断的。现在呢，你可以如你所愿的惩罚我。
So Lord Chaitanya was a bit angry and sad also to hear this.
对，主差太呀，听到这番话呢，他感到有一点愤怒，有一点悲伤。
Said you brought me here. The only possession which I had was that sannyasi rod. You did not keep it.
他说到呢，你们把我带到这里，我唯一的财产就是那根棍子，然而你们却没有保护好它。
So he said, "Now I don't want to go with you to Jagannath Puri." He said, "You can go before me, or I will go before you, but I'm not going with you. We'll have to separate."
所以呢，他就说，我现在不和你们一起去 Jagannath Puri 了，要么你们先走，要么我们先走，我先走。反正我们不会一起走了，我们单独行动。
So Mukunda told Lord Chaitanya, "Then you go first. We will come behind you. We shall not go with you. You go alone."
所以 Mukunda Datta 就说到呢，您走在前面，我们其他的人呢就跟在你后面，我们不和您一起走，您先走吧。
So Lord Chaitanya walked very quickly and he ran off to Jagannath Puri. So devotees were all puzzled. Why did Lord Nityananda break the sannyasi rod? And why did Lord Chaitanya become angry?
出现怎么不明白？为什么尼加南达帕布把这个棍子折断了？他们也不明白为什么财塔亚马哈帕布生气了。
So it's a very deep pastime. Not everyone can understand the significance, the meaning behind this.
这是一个非常深奥的逍遥时光。不是每个人都能够理解这个事情的。
You have to have faith in Gordon and Lord Chaitanya and Lord Nityananda.To understand.
要理解这个逍遥时光的话，我们必须对主查坦亚和主尼加兰达有坚定的心情。
So there are four points about the story of Sakshi Gopal.
对于这个 Sakshi Gopal 的故事呢，有四个要点。
First of all, that the deity is Satchidananda Vigraha.It's not material, it's eternal, full of bliss and knowledge.
首先呢，这个神像它是沙奇安南达维瓦哈，它并不是物质的。这个神像它是永恒，充满知识、极乐和全知的。
And then second point is, the deity is transcendental. It's not subject to any kind of material rules or regulations.
这个神像它是完全超然的，受这种物质的规范原则的这个限制。
And if one is a brahmana, third thing, if one is a brahmana, he has to follow the regulative principles very carefully.
然后呢，第三点就是说，如果你是一个 brahmana, 一个婆罗门的话，那你就必须要非常小心的去遵守规范守则。
And finally, Lord Krishna is very dear to the cows and the brahmanas.
那第四点呢，就是主 Krishna 对于母牛和 brahmana 是非常亲切的。
And the devotees are all protected by Krishna.
所有的奉献者都在主 Krishna 的庇护之下。
And such a devotee is a brahmana.One who is protected by Krishna is a brahmana.
一个受到 Krishna 庇护的人呢，是一位 Brahmana。
Okay, so that's the story. We'll finish here today.
所以这就是我们今天所要讲述的故事。
Is there any final question?
大家现在还有什么问题吗？No question at present.
Okay. So thank you very much. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ki.
Jai.
Srila Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki.
Jai.
Jai.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Ganan Gurudev Dinan Tsujanka.
Hare Krishna, Ganan Guru.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.